Hey guys, Coach Chris again. I wanted to do a little bit of a defensive strategy video today. So we've got the slate with us. I've had a few questions about where am I supposed to be on defense? How do I, push them to the outside? What does it all mean? Building the house, zones. Also, you notice I'm wearing the pink team Terra jersey. That's dedicated to a friend of mine who was diagnosed with cancer. When you are in your own end, you're going to break the rink down into four zones. At any time along the rink, if you don't know where to be, default to one of these four zones. Put a body here in these four zones. No matter what they do, no matter where they move throughout the board, you're gonna have somebody covering them. If he goes here, that's this guy's man. If he goes in here, he's this guy's man. If you default to one of these four positions, you're always gonna be okay positionally. If you find yourself over here with two of your buddies, you're gonna leave a lot of open space here on the rink. Once it's deep in your own zone, those bottom two zones are where you guys default to. When we're talking down low in the zone, what we mean is this area down here, down low. All right, when you're going up high, obviously, slot is the middle area where the highest percentage of goals are scored along the rink. Now from a defensive strategy, you look at these exit points right here, that's just the sign of the boards, because you're gonna exit along the boards. Anytime you're in a panic and you're looking where to go, you see the guy up at the point, if you hit the board right here from pretty much anywhere, that's gonna bank off into the point. If you get the puck right here and you're jammed up, you just slam it over here. Worst case scenario, it gives your people time to get back in. So, now, talk about building the house. The house is something that you build when you're A, on a penalty kill, or B, any other time you're playing defense. The house starts from the dots, goes down to the goal lines, comes up in a pointy fashion, like that, and literally looks like a house. Now the point of the house is you're trying to push the opposition to the outside of the perimeter of your house. You've got to assume that that's a solid structure. No one from the other team should ever be allowed in this area. If you're playing defense and you're right here, and you've got a player who's moving in on you, right? Offensive player's coming in on you, you're gonna wanna start here and push him to the outside of your house. You don't want him in your house. You see how these lines don't go all the way down here? In the world of hockey, if you are behind the net and you don't have the puck, you're in a bad spot. It's very difficult for you to get back from behind the net back to where you're supposed to be, protecting your house, if you're down here. If you're down here in the corner fighting someone, if they get that puck here where they want it to go, you're in trouble. Stay this line as your perimeter line. That's about where you should be at all times. If you find yourself over here fighting along the boards, you better pray that you've got some backup over here in your spot, because if you remember our little zone lines, they're about right here. That's a big area for you to cover if you're all the way over here. Exit strategy. Anytime that you have the puck and you're in your zone, you always exit the boards. You never go through the middle. We say it time and time and time again. The reason is remember our house? That's a solid structure. We don't go through our house because the puck can't literally move through our house. So if I'm coming in and I've got the puck right here, I'm gonna swing around and I'm gonna use this as an outlet, either with the puck so I can send it off the boards like that, so the puck goes down, or I can send it around to my defensive partner who's over here hanging out waiting for that puck. If there's a player in the corner with the puck, his ability to shoot this puck into the net is zero. Unless he gets some lucky bounce off the goalie or hits your skate or some other weird phenomenon. Again with the house. If I'm gonna defend against this player, there's no reason for me to go and attack him in our zone, right? He's there, he's no threat to me. A player who's coming in and moving into my house, that's a threat. That's why I need to make sure that I stay right around this area. So if he does move around here, or if he moves over here, that's fine. I still can protect my goalie from the outside. My objective here at all times is to stay between the man with the puck and the net. If I walk along the perimeter of my house, at all times, staying between the man and the net, he's never gonna get a good, clean, quality shot on the net. The problems come when I try and attack him and he goes around me. Then I'm no longer between the player who has the puck and the net. A couple of things to recap when we're talking about defense. Positionally, always stay between the man with the puck and the net. Secondly, never, ever, 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 ever pass through the middle. You've got to assume that that house that you built in the middle is a solid object. You cannot pass pucks through there. Defensive pairs work together. You should always have line of sight with your defensive partner. So if he moves back to the back side of the rink, you should be moving back to the back side of the rink. That way he has an outlet, either to go out the boards, to skate around who's attacking him, or to make a pass over to you, working as a pair. Lastly, when you're thinking about where should I be, and you see that puck is in the corner, let that guy go get it. He still has to get between you and the net, right? So there's a big obstacle between him and his objective, which is to put the puck on the net. We'll be right back.